it's Bradley from Tread Labs. Today we're going to be doing a CBXR install, and I'm also going to do a range test, show you how far you can get on the CBXR battery. It's an upgrade for the Onewheel XR by Chai Battery Systems. I'd like to thank them for sending this to me, and here we go. All you need for the install are some snippers or anything to cut with. You're cutting plastic, so it doesn't need to be really that skookum. Phillips head screwdriver, and 3x32 hex key. And then of course you're gonna need your old battery module with your batteries that need upgrading. So let's dive in. All right, so we're gonna be unscrewing those 5 screws with the Phillips head screwdriver. I'm not showing you how to disassemble the one wheel in this video to get the battery out. That's fairly simple. All you need is your Allen key. There's plenty of YouTube videos on how to disassemble a board. So you can check any of those out. There we go. Next, we take our hex key. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if you can see it, we have 4 here as well. So go ahead and do that. All of those ones. Now that we've undid all the screws, can open this guy up. Okay, so now for the removal of the original battery. I was told it's very important to unplug this first and then plug this back in last. To unplug this, you just lift up, pull, go. Now what we're cutting right now is not much. So the only thing we need to cut here is this. So I forgot to mention you need a ruler, so grab a ruler and you're gonna measure from 5 centimeters in and then 1.5 centimeters across. So that is what you're going to cut, and that's when these cutters come in handy. Might slide that out of the way a little bit so I'm not accidentally cutting that. I think that's cut right through. Okay, so now that we have the cut there, I'll admit not the best cut, but it should do. It's mentioning that you want the thin wires underneath and you want the thick wires running on top. So, in order to do that, I'm just gonna undo this one. Sits on top. These ones are supposed to go under the battery. Making sure they're not getting pinched in there. They look like they're all on their track. You just want to make sure that these are slightly above on top, but like routed on the side here, and try to make that not pop out when you put the battery back in. So make sure that's in there a little better. There we go. So we'll place that on like so. Flip this upside down for you. And let's start putting the screws back in.
want to make sure that's going in there.
Now, I think you can see how this is hitting the plastic, so it's not going to go in like that. You just need to push this down. I think that should work.
Sealed up. It's time to put this back into the one wheel and take it for a test ride. We'll see how many kilometers, miles I can get on it.
All right, so let's do that range test on the CBXR. Just for reference, I'm 170 pounds running the Hoosier Whisper at 17 PSI, and I also just replaced the bearings with fresh SKF bearings, which won't increase your range by replacing the bearings unless your bearings are completely shot, but just thought I would mention all that. For reference. So let's do a little tour of Vancouver, shall we? And this is my neighborhood. Just cruising up to, we're gonna do a little ride all along the beaches. So I'm just approaching the gravel path on Jericho Beach, and which will obviously affect the range a little bit, but I thought I should ride in mixed conditions to get a more accurate range test. As mentioned earlier, I'm riding with 17 PSI, which seems to be the perfect street riding PSI for me. If you go with the whole divide your weight by 10 thing, this works well for me as I'm 170 pounds. I usually prefer to ride at 14 to 15 PSI on trails though. Here's a little single track that I always love riding, except it's become a little sketchy with some of these deep sand potholes. We often take group rides down this path, but the gravel path can kick up a lot of dust when we have a dry spell, so people don't like it so much. Now I'm riding up a very steep hill toward the University of British Columbia. It's hard to tell how steep it is in the video, but the cyclists behind me are really struggling. I'm riding around 29 to 30 kilometers an hour. For my American friends, that's about 18 miles per hour, just over pushback speed. And I'm feeling really good. There's no surging at all, and I'm probably about 90% battery life left. I continue to ride at this speed for the duration of the video. Okay, so now at this point I've rode about 21 kilometers, which is about 13 miles, and I'm sitting at just over 60% battery life. I still feel like I've got a full battery with no surging or voltage sag, riding at a pretty consistent 29 to 30 kilometers an hour, 18 miles per hour. I'm in South Vancouver right now, riding their Butte Greenway, and I'm going to try to make it to go downtown around Stanley Park and the seawalls and then back to my apartment. We'll see. All right, so as I cross this bridge, I'm at around 53% battery. I haven't even gone through half the battery yet, and I've gone 30 kilometers, which is 18 miles, which tells me that I can likely get around 60 kilometers on this battery. Let's see, there's some steep hill climbs in Stanley Park that I still have to do, but for now, check out the view from the Burrard Street Bridge in beautiful Vancouver, British Columbia, Canada. Okay, so I am 19 miles into the trip and I finally hit 50% battery. And honestly, I can say that's way more than I was expecting to go on this thing, especially with me riding pretty fast at pushback speed. I haven't really taken any breaks. My feet are starting to get a little tired. This has been a continuous 19 miles, other than stopping at like a stop sign or stoplight or whatever. All right, so this is the start of the seawall in Cole Harbor, Vancouver. I'm gonna ride the seawall toward Stanley Park seawall, but my Insta360R camera that I'm currently recording with is about to die. So I need a CBXR battery for this thing apparently. So I'm gonna switch to my iPhone video after this dies, but enjoy the views. Here I am at the start of Stanley Park. Across the way is downtown, where I just rode from. If you're ever in Vancouver, Stanley Park is a must-visit spot. It's just so beautiful here, especially in the summer when it's sunny. The rest of the year it's raining, so we don't get much snow, but it rains a lot. Across the way there is the famous Lionsgate Bridge. And this is the steepest hill climb of the entire ride. A lot of cyclists get off their bikes and end up walking it. It's pretty brutal. But yeah, I don't have any surging at all, and I feel like I have 100% XR, regular XR battery.
I just checked and I have 35% left. I don't know if I'm gonna finish a whole battery today, guys. My feet are killing me. We'll see. I'm gonna do a loop around the seawall, essentially going from where I'm sitting now to the other side of the water, all along that seawall. I don't know how many kilometers that is, but I'm gonna do that, end up close to where I live, and see how many kilometers that, see where the battery is. But all I can say is, if you're on the fence of getting this battery, just do it. It's amazing. You can't even, like, you'll get too sore before you can outpace this battery. But if you want to do a long trip, take some breaks, long group rides, and not have to worry about bringing your charger, this is the wheel. It's awesome, especially if you ride trails too, and that you'll eat up the battery quicker, obviously, but you could ride trails for probably 2 hours. Which is insane. Maybe a little bit less than that, but still. Anyway, my 2 cents. Oh, by the way, shout out to The Float Life and Kate, who designed the shirt, but get one, floatlife.com. Cheers.
All right, so this map actually glitches right here. I actually did the whole loop around the water, so my final kilometers were all messed up, so I don't really repost that, but I'm almost there. Almost killed my battery.
Hey, we did it. I went 54 kilometers. There is my board that just Captain Morgan'd on me. I went 54 kilometers, which is about, oh geez, what is that in miles? I think 33 and a half miles. So the CBXR upgrade almost doubles your battery, and I was riding pretty fast the whole time, riding pushback, riding some trails, and I actually died on a gravel trail. So I have about a kilometer and a half to walk, which is a little brutal. Oh well, it was worth testing, so thanks for sticking through it.